Hello friends, welcome to LabTechs. My name is Dildar Khan and today we will discuss the practical application of whatever we have read or discussed in our theory class of the switching section. Everything that we have discussed starting from the resistor, capacitor, inductor, coil, and you talk about diode, Zener diode, BJT, MOSFET, operational amplifier, everything we will teach or we will demonstrate you on the practical motherboard step by step. What you have to follow, you have to first watch all the theoretical videos and then corresponding practical videos you have to watch simultaneously so that you get perfect knowledge of diagnosing a motherboard from the chip level, starting from these basic components of the switching sections. So today I'm going to start with this practical session. So I hope you have already watched our diode, Zener diode and gate videos in our classes, in our theory classes to be precise. And now I'll demonstrate it on this motherboard, practical motherboard, that how those components or those devices practically works in a motherboard in a cold testing as well as in the hot testing. And this is a Sony MBX250 motherboard. All the MBX motherboard of Sony are approximately similar. So in this section, there is a DC in section where I will demonstrate you. So this is the DC jack where power is inputted into the motherboard. And this area is the DC in section, including in this side also. Some components are in the other side of the motherboard. So this is the DC in section and this is also the DC in section. This is the battery connector. Some components are also from the GPU section as well, but we will not go into that. We'll see all the DC in sections and specifically you will see the diodes and the Zener diodes working, as well as we'll go to the 3 volt 5 volt section. As you can see, this is the coil, these are the high drive and low drive MOSFETs, these are the capacitors, and in this section there will be a Zener diode which we will discuss how it is working in this motherboard. This has a TPS 51427 3 volt 5 volt IC that I have discussed in the class. Later on you can watch that video and understand the logic. So here I will demonstrate you how the LDO is generated in the motherboard using this Zener diode, particularly in this board. So we will see that also later on. I will show you in the schematics how it works. But first of all, I will let you know all the cold testing of these sections. For this I have to go to the schematic and find out which component are located on which side and what is the numbering there so that I can find it easily. Let's go to the schematics. So I have already opened it for you, no need to search for it. I have opened the DC in section. As you all know, I have discussed this DC in section in our DC in class. You can watch it later. Right now I am not going into that concept. I am going into the concept of the diode as well as the Zener diode. So this you can see here, PD31, this is the it's a network diode, as a combination of three diodes. So as you can see, these two terminals are crossed, so only two diodes are used in this motherboard, right? And this is a Zener diode. As we have already discussed, this is a 2.7 volt Zener diode, and also one Zener diode is there in the DC in section, basically in the input of the 3 volt 5 volt section to enable the LDO. We will see that later on. Right now I am going to demonstrate you this PD31, which is a network diode that we will discuss in the motherboard. So let's get on to the practical board now. So as you can see, this is my jumper that I have connected to the DC in section, and I have not applied any power to this motherboard. It's a bare board. And now I'll let you know what are the components that I have just searched. I have searched PD31. So let me check on the board, where is PD31. Let me turn on my multimeter. So this is PD16, this is PD31. I have already marked it. This is PD16, which is a Zener diode, and this is PD31, which is a network normal diode, silicon diode, which you can see from the schematics. You can open Sony MBX269 schematics, both are similar. You can get reference from that board as well. So let me check the cold testing. As you know, diode works in the two mode, forward mode and the reverse mode. So I have to put this in the ohm value. I'll let you know in the volt mode as well as in the ohm mode. So I've just put in the resistor ohm mode, and let me check whether the diode is open or shorted. As you know, if it will be shorted, you will get a beep sound, and if it is open, you will get overload, that is over the limit, which is not detectable by our multimeter. So let's check this network diode. You can observe here, this is PD31, and I can tell you what which is the starting terminal. So let me check it by this lens. So this one is the first terminal, and anti-clockwise I have to number it. So this is the first terminal that I can detect from here. So let me check it either way. This is the first terminal, and anti-clockwise, or you can say in a U shape, you have to number the terminals. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So my 1 to 6 terminal is connected to the first diode. So I am checking from the first to the sixth terminal. From the first to the sixth terminal, you can see here. From the first, I have put my negative terminal of the multimeter on the first terminal, which is the anode, while I have put my positive on the cathode of the first diode. So you can see this is in the reverse direction, and the reverse direction you see 1.96 mega ohm. It's approximately 2 mega ohm resistor value or the impedance value that is coming from this diode, and it is not beeping. So it is not even open, or it is not even short. It is in the good condition. Now let me check it the other way by interchanging the probes. Now I've just interchanged the probes, and now you can see the value on the multimeter. It is coming just 80 kilo ohms. So by this way, you can observe that in the forward direction, in the forward bias mode, I should say. So in forward bias condition, diode's impedance value is low. It is approximately 80 kilo ohms. While when in the reverse direction, its value will become a high value, which is a 2 mega ohm, is quite high value. By this, you can conclude that diode is not open by either way, in the forward direction as well as in the reverse direction. So this network diode's first diode is working quite fine. Now let me check the second diode. Again, you can find it. It is coming approximately the same 70 kilo ohms. It is coming in the forward direction. And let me interchange the probe and see what is the value coming. Again, you see it is coming approximately 2 mega ohms. So it means our diode is working very good in the forward as well as in the reverse direction. So this is the cold testing of the diode that you can do while you are checking your motherboard in the cold testing. So now we will go into the hot testing, or rather I would like to test Zener diode as well in the cold testing. Then simultaneously we will check both the normal diode as well as the Zener diode in the hot testing, so that it will be easy for me to demonstrate you in the same manner. So let's check the cold testing of the Zener diode now. So for that, let me go to the schematics now. I'll go to the 3 volt 5 volt section. I'll type 51427. It is TPS 51427. It's a 3 volt 5 volt IC. As I taught you in the class, in the theory class, this is the 3 volt 5 volt section. As you know, enable LDO is required to generate LDO voltage in this 3 volt 5 volt standby section. I'll not go into the deep. You can go for reference to our 3 volt 5 volt section video, where you can find all the information related to the 3 volt 5 volt section, internal logic, as well as the fault condition and what you have to do in different fault situations. So now this is the PD7. As you see, this is the V-in voltage of this 3 volt 5 volt standby section. This is the PD7. As already discussed in the theory class, that how do you determine the rating of a diode, or a Zener diode to be precise. This is a 5 volt Zener diode. As you can see, UDZS 5.1B, B is its tolerance value. 5.1 volt is a 5 volt Zener diode. You can observe it. As I told you in the theory, Zener diode can be used in a series circuit as well as in a parallel circuit. When Zener is used in a parallel circuit, it works as a voltage regulator, while when it is used in a series circuit, it will work as a voltage consumer. So it will consume 5 volt when it is connected in the series. So you can observe here, it will consume 5 volt when it is connected in the series, while when it is connected in the parallel, it will maintain that 5 volt across the load where it is connected. So both, either way, you can use a Zener diode as a normal diode as well as a parallel voltage regulator. So in this condition, as you can see in the schematics, it is connected in series to a voltage divider resistor. So here it is used as a voltage drop component. So here it will drop the voltage. How much voltage it will drop? It will drop the value of its Zener voltage value. When it will drop the Zener voltage value, you can reference to my theory class, where I have explained everything about it. When it will work as a voltage regulator, when it will work as a series voltage drop. So let me do it practically that how this will work as a voltage regulator now. So let me find out PD7 is there. This is also a 3 volt 5 volt in the 3 volt 5 volt section. So I told you this is a 3 volt 5 volt IC. So I couldn't find that here. Let me turn it over. So this is, I think this is the one. This is PD7. As I would like to show you in a close snap, this is, you can see here, this is PD7 and this is the Zener diode that I am talking about, and these two are the resistors that are connected in series to this Zener diode. We'll just find it out again. I'll let you know. So this is the resistor. So as you can observe here, this resistor is giving me a beep sound with the ground. It means one, this is PR304. You also reference to the schematic at the same time. This is giving me ground, so it is PR304 and it is connected to ground, and the second terminal is not connected to ground, so it means this is the mid terminal of the voltage divider. Now let me check the Zener value in the forward as well as in the reverse direction. I don't know, as of now I don't know what is the, which terminal is anode and which terminal is cathode, but let me just check it randomly. I've just put my multimeter here and I've just changed it to ohm value. Now you can observe here, it is coming approx 0.5 mega ohm. I don't know direction it is in. Let me just interchange the probe. It is not giving me beep sound, so I will say that it is not shorted. Now you see here, it is 430. It is also 0.5 mega ohm. So in Zener value, you will observe that in both the direction, because Zener also works in the reverse direction as well as in the forward direction. So its value will be different from the normal diode. You have to remember this point. Whenever you, if you don't have a diode and you don't know which diode is connected here, so you have to just check it either way by changing the probe. You will get approximately the same value from both the sides. Then it will decide that it is a Zener diode, and for the normal diode in the forward direction you will get the less value, and for the reverse direction you will get a mega ohm value. In the forward direction you will get kilo ohm value, and in the reverse direction you will get mega ohm value for a normal diode. From this coil testing you can just observe that this diode is Zener or not. You can observe here from by interchanging terminal, again I am getting 0.5 mega ohm, so you cannot identify that it is open or short. It is a Zener diode, so from both the terminal you will get higher value. So now we are going in to check the hot testing of this motherboard for our diode as well as for our Zener diode one by one, as I have already done cold testing for the diode, and then I'll first do the hot testing for the diode, and simultaneously I'll do the hot testing for our Zener diode as well. So just let me plug in the power. I have to just put the alligator clip in the ground and put power supply here. Right.
Just remove it like this.
Okay. Now I have to check the diode. So diode is in the other side. Diode is on the other side. So let me just turn it over. And here was the diode. So it would be convenient for me to just put ground here. Right. So now, let me just turn it on. Now you see the multimeter. I'm just putting it on this diode PD1, or you can say PD31. On PD31, I've put the multimeter pin number 1. I just need to my ground is not properly connected. You can observe here, I've put it here, but you need to take care of this as well. Just try to fix it somewhere else. Now let me check whether my 19 volt has entered into the motherboard. Now you can see my 19 volt is there on the motherboard, on the DC in section or the DC jack where I put this jumper. Now let me check this PD31. This is the PD31. This is the 19 volt at the input of the PD31 first diode. Now let me check on the output. As you can observe here, the 19 volt is switched onto the other side. It means my diode is working fine And also you need to observe this voltage. This is 19.24 volt and this is 19.67 volt. So as I told you in the class, there would be approximately 0.5 to 0.7 volt drop in the diode when it is switched on. So this anode is greater than the cathode, so it is switched on and 19.6 volt is coming at the anode of the diode. And now let me check at the cathode of the diode. Cathode, you are getting 19.23 volt. It means 0.5 approximately volt is getting dropped. So this diode is working fine. This way you should confirm that my diode is working fine. There should be a slight voltage drop from the input to the output. If there is no voltage drop between input and the output, it means our diode is shorted. So you need to confirm it by hot checking as well. Okay, so this is working very fine.